BeamBrush is a new element of your laser projector, which, like scanners and colors in your laser, has its own control parameters. To change those parameters, we have added a tab in our projector settings window. To get to the projector settings window, we go to Settings, Projector Settings. Select the FP4 controller that you would like to configure and go to the BeamBrush tab. Note, the BeamBrush tab will only appear when your projector has BeamBrush built inside. The first thing we want to do is enable BeamBrush. This will reveal all the settings available to us. There are three main adjustments you'll make to our BeamBrush to act exactly the way we want. First is scaling, minimum and maximum brushing. Second is an XY offset, and finally, the shift and slew rate. In output scaling and linearity correction, we can set our minimum and maximum brush, and if needed, a curve. It's unlikely this will be anything other than linear due to how the BeamBrush device works, but we've added it just in case. This works just like in the advanced color correction settings, and you can use your arrow keys to shift up and down selected points. Use this to determine your maximum brush, or possibly minimum, that you will want to use on your projector. Next, let's look at the XY shift compensation. BeamBrush systems, as they move through the brush values, will create a slight XY shift in output. This can be minimized with perfect alignment, but in the reality of the touring world, this is unachievable. So we've added an XY compensation to tune this shift. The 0% and 100% are calculated before output scaling and linearity. This means that tuning this option will always be for 100% possible brush. It won't change if you change your minimum and maximum brush values in the output scaling section. For the XY offset, you can select each tuning point and use the grid here to move them into place. The test pattern will display a 0% brush square and the tuning point brush square on top. The goal was to center the brush square on the 0% brush square. You will do this for each percentage to correct for the XY offset. Beyond will smoothly go between each tuning point when you select them, so you can see if your adjustments worked. You can also change the pattern's colors here. First square is 0% brush, and the second is the brush color. New BeamBrush projectors from Quant will have the XY shift already completed from shipment and stored on the FP4 itself. Changes here will be on top of those settings originally created by the manufacturer. As one more note, if you need to go beyond the visual graph, you can go further by entering the value here, or by clicking on the arrows and dragging with your mouse up and down. For timing and shift compensation, we have the first BeamBrush timing shift. This is like color shift and changes how early the instructions are sent to the BeamBrush mechanism compared to XY scanner position and color timing, as they all react at different rates. 4 is a good default shift for 3mm systems up to 10 watts, and 6 is a good default shift for 5mm systems from 10 watts to 40 watts. The slew rate limiter is a calculation that Beyond makes to sudden transitions between brush sizes to correctly time themselves out. So a sudden change in effect looks like a sudden change in real life. A slew rate of 1.0 should work for the default maximum brush size that came with shipped with your projector. However, if you change the minimum maximum size of the brush from the hardware standpoint with tuning, you may need to adjust this. Lower number for less overall brush and higher for higher overall brush. We can use this line test pattern to set these two values. You can see how the two values affect the pattern. We want the white bars to be perfectly matched to the brush size they are, and the red lines to be perfectly zero brush, without any overlap between them. Just pressing OK will save these settings to the temp file on your PC, but you can also save this projector's settings to a file using this tool, and BeamBrush settings will be saved along with all the other settings in this window. In the end, your test pattern should look like this. The circle pattern will look like the progressively wider circle will be smoothly increasing on all sides of the inner circle. And with the line test pattern, we'll have the white lines brushed correctly and the reds at zero brush without any colors being shown have the brush sizes they should not have. Thanks for watching our quick hints video on using the BeamBrush settings in Beyond and setting up your BeamBrush projector properly. If you still have questions or need help, email support@pangolin.com and we can assist as soon as possible. Be sure to watch our other Quick Hints videos on the BeamBrush additions to Beyond to get the full picture.